G'day and welcome to Black Opal Direct. My name's Justin. Well, today I thought I'd wear a red shirt instead of a blue one because a lot of people are saying, do you only have blue shirts? So there you go. I do have something else. But today we're going to work on this piece. Now I did a post last week about the three main features of Knobby Opal from Lightning Ridge, and this piece is the piece that featured in it. So we're going to rub this piece up today and see what kind of an opal we can get out of it. And once I've cut that opal, we're going to talk about what makes this opal such a nice opal, or maybe not, depending on how it cuts. So I know everybody has said, how do you value an opal? And I figured the only way for you to learn how to value an opal is for me to go through the process of cutting it and then talk about its features to make it come up with a price. So let's do that and see if it helps you out a bit more. Let's get to it. So when we're looking at this opal, this piece of rough, so it's actually a knobby opal. We have a few different features. We have a white cap or top, which they can call, you can call crockery, white potch, matrix. There's a few other names that people might use. A lot of the time with these types of knobbies, the color can be sitting just underneath that white crockery top. And it's always a good sign when you see a piece of knobby opal in the parcel or in the rough that you've tailed out, the white cap. If you find a white cap, take that piece out and put it aside whether it has color or not, because there is a chance, and sometimes it's a small chance, but then other times you can sometimes see the color already, that there's a chance underneath that white pot, that white cap, is color. And just like this one, there is quite a thick color bar sitting underneath this one. So the idea is to rub that white cap off without losing any color. Now, on these color bars underneath, sometimes the best color and the most orange or red color can be just underneath the white cap. And if you rub down too far, it could go from a beautiful orange stone down to a green stone because you've taken the orange off the top. So, got to be really careful about rubbing these pieces up. So let's get on the wheel and let's take that top off and see what we've got. My prediction is a high domed little 1.5 to 2 carat stone. I could be wrong, and last week, as you saw, I was wrong. Didn't cut anywhere near the stone that I thought it would cut. So hopefully this week it works out better. Fingers crossed. Let's go. So here's the piece that we're about to work on. I'll just try and get it in focus. There we go. And you can see there is a color bar sitting underneath that white crockery top, and there's some potch on the back. Now I'm going to do a couple of tests and see, grind a bit of that potch because it's nice and thick, and see if it goes black. The chances are pretty slim, but it could go black. And then I'm going to take that white crockery top off and see how big a stone we have to work with. Now it's not going to be a big stone, and hopefully it will be bright and the pattern will be nice, but you never know until you get into it. So let's start doing it. I'll get the machine going. Okay, so you can see there the potch has turned black on the inside, or darker. Now my hope is that will turn dark onto the opal as well. There is a small chance it could. If it doesn't, then so be it. But it's a good telltale to say that this could be a decent stone. So the color bar is running around, looks pretty clean this side. I'm just gonna touch it on the wheel where the sand is, so I'm not losing anything, and see how much of that side has color bar that's clean. All right, so we have our color bar there. It's looking quite good, but There is some sand. Hang on, let's get it in focus. Sorry. There is some sand here on that end, on that side. But let's just take it down on the top. This is the biggest challenge. And the hope that she comes clean. Just started shining through there. You can see the color just starting to show through. Okay, so we keep going. Get that potch clean off the top. Please be clean. Please play the right game for us. Okay, so the colour is starting to come through a bit more. Now I've got to be super cautious of not losing that nice orangey red on the top. In the same time, I have to get all of the potch out of the face, so it can be a bit of a challenge. Going to work around the edge of the color bar to try and get it just where the edge of the color bar sits, and there's no sand, and then we can work on a stone, work on an opal that lends itself to this piece. Just get a little bit of that off a bit faster. So you can see there, it's turned real black right in the middle. Okay. So I finished rubbing out this beautiful opal, and it has turned out way better than I ever imagined. What a beautiful stone. The color play, the red, the brightness is so strong. There was a high dome as I did predict, but I didn't expect it to be that bright. The black potch that as it went in, as I ground into the piece, that potch from the gray outer turned into black inside. Now I think, or dark, it touches the color just. So I think I've got a darker stone, but I don't know if I've got a black opal yet. Once I've finished polishing it up, I'll put it on the body tone scale and we'll have a look and see where it sits. And then we'll go through a price and we'll try and learn something from there. But right now, I'm gonna put it on the stick, polish it up. I won't show you this process because we go through that quite a bit. And we will come up with a price after I'm finished. Let's get to it. Cutting that fast is thirsty work. So now I've polished up the opal. I've got a beautiful high dome. It ended up being a 1.84 carat stone. Now I was hoping for 2, but the the rough part of the opal was still showing on one side, and it was like a gouge. So it was misshaping the opal from the top. So I had to bring round up that back just a little bit more, just to get rid of that gouge out of the side, so it became a more pleasing stone. And because it's such a top gem, it needs to be precise, it needs to be accurate. You don't want it to be wonky, because when somebody puts it in a piece of jewelry, they see beautiful color but not a well balanced piece of jewelry, then you'll always look at it and wonder. But if it's a perfect stone, and I love perfect stones, it can make the jewelry look absolutely sublime. So let's give this a bit of a pricing on this stone. I've got my body tone scale here, which you can buy in the on our website. We've got new stock. It's a credit card material, and they're quite robust. And have a look under tools and guides on my website, and you will find them there. So when we value an opal, we always make sure that we've got a daylight window or a sunlight window, not direct sunlight, but shaded light coming in. Always have that light to the back of you when you're looking at the opal, because you want the light to hit the opal so you can see the color the best you can possibly see. And that way you'll be able to, if you keep that same type of light every time you look at your opal, you can get a gauge. If you look at opal under different lights all the time, then you won't get a good idea about value, because opal looks different under every different type of light. Okay, so my go-to is daylight, because it's always going to be the same light, the same warmth, the same cool, same everything, and I will get a very similar price every time. So this opal, because it's so beautiful, it's got red, orange, green and blue in it, and it's a 5 out of 5 on the brightness scale. It does make it on the body tone scale, it makes it to just on N4, which I am absolutely happy about. Makes it a black opal, which is just unreal for me. I love my black opal, and I think it's worth around about the $5,000 a carat, because it's so beautiful. The brightness, the red and the high dome, the cut, and the way the color play moves around, it is just a brilliant opal. Anyway, I hope you've learned something here today, and sorry about some of the silliness, but comes with me. I'm just a silly person. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.